Jai Hind, my dear students. Today we are moving to another topic in financial statement. In the last classes, we have learned about the preparation of vertical form of balance sheet, its headings, subheadings, and everything. My dear students, it shows the financial position of an organization. Today, we are going to learn how we can find out the profit or loss by preparing statement form of profit and loss. Statement of profit and loss. You know very well, in sole trading concerns, they are preparing profit and loss account in debit and credit rules using the account format. Here, in the case of a company, they are preparing the statement of profit and loss. So remember, we have to know the format very clearly. First of all, look at the format. So this is the format showing how we can record the items in a statement of profit and loss. It have different parts. We can find out the items like that revenue from operation. It shows the total sales revenue. If there is any other income, it will be added. Total revenue will be the revenue from operation plus other incomes. Then there will be expenses, it will be deducted. Cost of material consumed is the one item. Purchase of stock in trade, change in inventory of finished goods, work in progress, stock in trade, employee benefit expenses, finance cost, depreciation or amortization expenses, and other expenses. So first of all, we will find out the total revenue. Then we will find the total expenses. The difference between these two are known as profit before tax. Profit before tax. And remember, that is the way to find out the amount of profit or loss. Then we will deduct the tax amount. Also, we will adjust the amount after tax. It will be profit after tax. So keep in mind, we are going to learn in detail what is the different item explains. So don't forget to watch the entire video. Keep in mind the format: total revenue minus expense, that is the profit during a year, financial year. So let us begin with the first item, that is revenue from operation. We are getting revenue from various sources. It may be the revenue from sale of product, revenue from sale of services, other operating revenue such as sale of scrap materials. So if there is any amount of return inward, it will be deducted. Sales return will be deducted. So revenue from sale of product less return, we will get gross revenue from, or the different amount of revenue from operation. And revenue from sale of services are there, and other operating incomes like or revenues like sale of scrap material after production. Also, it includes items like interest income, dividend income, net gain or loss on sale of investment, revenue from other financial services. Interest income, you know very well, when the company invests in the debenture, or they deposit the amount of money in bank, then we will get interest. And dividend income, it is related to share. Okay, when the company invests in some other company's share, then we will get dividend. So that is the thing. And when there is a sale of investment, if there is any net gain or loss on sale of investment, here gain will be considered. And revenue from other financial services also considered under the heading revenue from operation. Also, some more items are there. What we told, the items already we have discussed. And other incomes are there, like rent received on building, premises, etc. using machine, discount received, commission received, profit on sale of fixed asset, sale of miscellaneous items, maybe newspapers or scrap water maybe, and also refund of income tax. These are the items coming under revenue from operation. So my dear students, these are the items. Again, you can remember all the items like revenue from operation, other incomes like rent received, interest received, dividend received, discount received, commission received, profit on sale of fixed asset, refund of income tax by the government. All these things are examples for revenue. We will find the total revenue by adding all these items. Then we have to deduct some expenses like a cost of material consumed. You know very well, cost of material consumed means what? The amount spent by the company for the production of the product. So remember, cost of material consumed means the cost of raw material and other material consumed in manufacturing the goods. For the production of goods and services, what we spend, that is cost of material consumed. And there is a small formula you have to keep in mind for the calculation of the value of cost of material consumed. That is opening inventory of materials plus purchase of raw materials or any materials minus closing inventory. Please keep in mind this equation: opening stock of material plus purchased during the year, purchase of material during the year minus closing inventory. So that is the thing. And what is purchase of stock? So you know, some business firms, they will produce and distribute the product. Some business firms will purchase the material and distribute the product. That means they will collect from some manufacturers and distribute the product or sell the product. Here, purchase of stock means the amount spent for the purchase of stock or materials for reselling. That is the case. In case the company carries out further processing on the goods purchased, we can classify purchase of stock in trade. Likewise, if semi-finished goods or finished goods are purchased by this organization, maybe sometimes it will be used for further processing, and that total amount is known as purchase of stock in trade. So remember what is purchase of stock in trade. And there will be some changes happening for the amount of inventory, like finished goods, work in progress, stock in trade. All these things we have to calculate separately. We want to know what is the change happened for finished goods. Then please use the equation: opening inventory of finished goods minus closing inventory of finished goods. So my dear students, remember how to calculate the value of change in finished goods: opening inventory of finished goods minus closing inventory of finished goods. If the question is to find out the value of change in work in progress, like the same, opening inventory of work in progress minus closing inventory of work in progress. If we want to find out the value of change in stock in trade, stock in trade means what? The goods distributed for the business people for further sale. Still it is there in the market, we didn't get any money after its sales. So opening inventory of stock in trade minus closing inventory of stock in trade, that is the equation we have to keep in mind. And another expenses include employee benefit expenses. Lot of amounts are spent by the organization for the employee benefits like wage, salary, bonus, leave, encashment. Sometimes when the employees are taking leave, they will get the salary for that day also. So wages, salary, bonus, leave, encashment, contribution to provident fund by the company, other funds like gratuity fund, superannuation fund. These type of funds are spent for the benefit of the employees. Staff welfare expenses such as canteen expenses. You know very well, most of the organization, they are giving the lunch and breakfast for cheap rate than the normal business hotels. So medical expenses, expenses on employee stock option scheme. Stock option scheme, it is related to stock ESOS and ESPP are related to the issue of share to the workers. So they will get a share of the company where they are working at less price. That type of expenses are coming under employee benefit expense. And other type of expense include finance cost, interest, and finance cost. You know very well, the amount spent for collecting funds. When we are taking loan from bank, we are paying the interest. When we are issuing debenture and collecting amount, that time also we are paying the amount of money as interest. So it includes examples like interest expenses, such as interest paid on term loan from bank, and interest paid on overdraft on or interest paid on debenture, bonds, public deposits, and also other borrowing cost will include. This will include discount or loss on issue of debenture, premium payable on redemption of debenture, debenture return off, loan processing charges. You know, when we go through bank to collect loan, they will collect some money as the processing charge. So these are collectively known as finance cost. Remember, all these expenses are related to raising funds, maybe by issuing share or debenture, or especially issuing debenture, collecting bank loan, etc. So keep in mind what is finance cost, another category under the heading expense. And depreciation, you know very well. Amortization also you know very well. The decline in the value of tangible and intangible asset is known as depreciation and amortization. And what are the items separately comes here? Depreciation, it is the cost of tangible fixed asset written off. And what is amortization? It is the cost of intangible fixed asset written off. So remember, depreciation is related to tangible asset. Amortization is also decline in the value of intangible asset like goodwill written off, patent written off, like that. And other expenses include lot of items like carriage, carriage inward, carriage outward, freight. All these things are very much familiar for you, know, manufacturing expenses, rental rate and taxes, insurance less prepaid if any, discount allowed, commission allowed, bad debts written off and provision for bad and doubtful debt, repair of machinery, building and other fixed asset, trade expenses. Also, administration, office and telephone expenses are coming under this category. So please keep in mind all these things. Also, other expenses, again, it includes bank charges, loss on sale of fixed asset, director's fee, board director's fee, and audit fee for the auditor, conveyance expense or traveling expense, courier expenses, telephone and interest expenses, entertainment expenses, share issue expenses written off, underwriting commission on issue of share written off. So all these things are coming under expenses. So my dear students, please remember the format when we go through the item in the statement of profit and loss. First of all, we will record all the revenue generating items, revenue from operation. Then we will record the items related to expenses, different classification of expenses. The difference, it will be profit before tax. Then we will find out the percentage of tax during the year. It will give the amount of tax. So please keep in mind all these things. And thank you. Have a nice day. And bye-bye. We have finished one chapter. We will meet in the next class with another chapter. Please work out maximum problems from this chapter.